there's no way, but I can keep dreaming and writing songs about us getting together. Cause at least this way, my words have meaning, as the likelihood of us is never. Cause I just keep dreaming, cause I just cause I just keep dreaming.
Welcome to this James Cook University graduation ceremony. Please ensure that all electronic devices are switched off. Graduates, you are reminded that protocol requires that you take off your mortarboard bonnet for the national anthem. Would the assembly please stand for the entrance of the academic procession?
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor and President, distinguished guests, members of the official party, academic staff, graduates and guests, good afternoon. Welcome to this College of Public Health, Medical and Veterinary Sciences, College of Healthcare Sciences, College of Medicine and Dentistry and College of Arts, Society and Education graduation ceremony. Would you please remain standing for the playing of the national anthem, which will be sung by Mrs. Ashley Bennett.
Australians, all let us rejoice, for we are one and free. We've golden soil and wealth for toil, our home is good by sea. Our land abounds in nature's gifts of beauty, rich and rare. In history's page, let every stage advance Australia fair. In joyful strains, and let us sing, advance Australia fair.
Thank you. Please be seated. Chancellor, I invite Mr. Brenton Creed to deliver the Welcome to Country.
Algo Nabal Nabal, Ninda Dangare, Nyan Yan Yarabinya, Mildin Gurumbulbra, Yumbinan, and Gal Gimga. Yeah, sorry. Sorry. I just totally forgot what I was going to say. Oh, English. Hello and welcome. I see people have arrived on my country, Townsville, Magnetic Island, and the Ross Creek. On behalf of my Woolgaroo Kabar traditional custodians, elders past, present, and emerging, welcome here today to your graduation ceremony for the JCU, for the College of Public Health, Medical and Veterinary Services, College of Healthcare Sciences, College of Medicine and Dentistry, and College of Arts, Society and Education. I'd like to thank JCU for following cultural protocol and ensuring that our First Nations voices are heard and respected. I'd like to say congratulations to our graduates here today because you've made it through all those trials and tribulations to get your certificate. Congratulations, pat on the back. Without further ado, I hope you all have a great future in your industries and enjoy the rest of your time here on country. Always was, always will be Aboriginal land. Thank you.
We are assembled here today to confer James Cook University Awards. May I take this opportunity to introduce members of the official party. My name is Tiana Graham. I am today's ceremony marshal and a proud JCU alumna. From my right, Associate Professor David Simcock, Acting Dean of the College of Public Health, Medical and Veterinary Sciences. Professor Pauline Kalija, Dean of the College of Healthcare Sciences. Professor Cohen Staplebrook, Dean of the College of Arts, Society and Education. Professor Ian Atkinson, Acting Dean of Graduate Research. Today's mace bearer, Chazelle Bovink. Miss Bovink is the Deputy University Secretary. Professor Nairi Brown, the University's Chancellor. Vice-Chancellor and President, Professor Simon Biggs. This afternoon's occasional speaker, Mr. Sean Chilbara. Ms. Jane Arlett, the University's Deputy Chancellor. Ms. Renee Siciliano, this afternoon's graduate speaker. Professor Marie Dynan-Thompson, Deputy Vice-Chancellor Education. Professor Jenny Seddon, Deputy Vice-Chancellor Research. Professor Stephen Naylor, Chair of the University's Academic Board. Seated behind the official party are members of the University Council and staff. Chancellor, I invite you to address the Assembly.
Kamarara, Majingal Muji Mitagar Gurmuruk, Numban Malada Nainura, Wulgarukaba, Garambilbara, Bindal, Fulgarawaji, Bebeguyumba, Naganbi, Nyagang, Nairi Brown, you and Mige. A warm welcome to you all. A friend is happy to see you. I bring with me love and respect from the peoples of my country to the traditional custodians of where we gather, raise our families, work, live and love. The Wulgarukaba peoples of Garambilbara, and also to their neighbours across the river, the Bindal peoples of Thulgariwaja, where our place of learning campus sits. My name is Nye Brown. I'm a Yuin Nation woman from the south coast of New South Wales and a proud alumna of James Cook University. I extend love and respect to each of you, to the award winners, the students and graduates and their families, my Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander brothers and sisters, to special guests and to staff. I am honoured and humbled to share in this ceremony. I see you and I embrace you. And what an extraordinary occasion. For each of you and your peers, a significant milestone marking the conclusion of one adventure and hopefully the beginning of another and many more beyond that. For your families, another proud moment in a journey that began the moment you were gifted to them. But also for JCU. Today and tomorrow, we are convening three cultural sashing ceremonies, three graduations for more than 1,300 eligible students, including PhD scholars university medalists and cum laude medalists, and many of whom would have commenced and or continued through the turmoil and uncertainty of COVID. Today we also celebrate the first cohort of the Graduate Certificate of Indigenous Studies. Far North Queensland is fortunate indeed to have such richness in cultural history, to be nestled within striking, abundant, wild, dangerous lands and waters, nurtured by thousands of generations of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples. Diversity is a blessing, bringing with it depth, growth, and opportunity. Each and every one of you has a cultural story to tell, irrespective of your background, your heritage, or your nation of origin. I hope you see fit to share some of that narrative as you are part of the local community. I hope your journey reveals to you a sense of belonging and of identity, two of the most significant determinants of social and emotional well-being. To know yourself will give you the fortitude to push through the most painful of challenges and cast a light to illuminate the darkest of days. For me, that's what it is to be an Aboriginal woman, secure in the knowledge of who I am, that I am connected and that I belong, that I am anchored no matter the tempest. A legacy of culture gifted by my father, my grandparents, my great-grandparents, all the way back until the first peoples were fashioned out of clay and ochre and earth. Now, I'm a doctor, I know where people actually come from, but I deeply believe in that metaphor, that we are from the earth, we shall return to it, and in between we must care for, protect and nurture. Indigenous wisdom is older than time, but as humble as a whisper, often difficult to directly translate, yet simple enough. At the heart of it is the supremacy of the natural world and the responsibility of humanity to Mother Earth and to one another. I encourage you all to seek purpose in service to our communities, local and global, now and always. Seven generations is a Haudenosaunee philosophy, that it is not enough to think only of our own generation or even that of our children or grandchildren. We must consider the echoes of our actions and decisions seven generations henceforth. Long before Western medicine and allied health systems took shape, every culture of the world had healers, shaman, traditional practitioners, with knowledges written on the heart and passed from generation to generation with pride. When I look to each of you, I recognise your intellect and your tenacity. I see before me leaders and innovators, creatives, change makers, role models. I applaud your hard work and the dedication that successful completion demands. I commend the networks that have supported your journeys, as no great thing is achieved in isolation. Please take a moment to express gratitude for the love and care you have received from family and friends, colleagues, peers, staff, sometimes complete strangers. Those who were there for you with a smile, a shoulder, a frosty beverage, a home-cooked meal, or the motivation that you needed at critical moments. I trust that JCU has contributed to your growth. And from all of us, I would like to thank you for privileging our institution with your presence and your contributions. Congratulations. Welcome to the JCU family. I am and we are truly proud of you. Nanda Wanjin.
Chancellor, I call upon the Chair of Academic Board, Professor Stephen Naylor, to present the graduating students.
Will all graduands please stand? Chancellor, I certify to you and to the University that all graduands standing before you today have fulfilled the requirements prescribed by the University, and I ask that they be admitted to their respective awards.
In the name of the University Council and by my authority as Chancellor, I admit all candidates so approved and congratulate and warmly welcome you all as James Cook University graduates.
Will all graduates please be seated?
Chancellor, the awarding of Doctor of Philosophy degrees has a special place in our graduation ceremony. It is one of the highest qualifications which the university awards. This degree is awarded for the successful completion of a significant piece of independent research sustained in a scholarly character and one which makes an original contribution to the field. External examination is always involved. 14 candidates will be presented this afternoon. Professor Ian Atkinson, Acting Dean of Graduate Research, will present the graduates and acknowledge their supervisors. And Professor Stephen Naylor, Chair of the Academic Board, will read the thesis abstracts.
Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. Vincent Zimibzi. Dr. Zimibzi's studies were undertaken in the discipline of veterinary studies under the supervision of Professor Bruce Gummow.
Chancellor, Dr. Zimibzi created a unique surveillance model to improve disease surveillance in South African village pigs and chickens. The model channels scarce resources and manpower into high-risk areas of market chain and allows cost-effective early detection and control of diseases that affect the livelihood of villagers. Chancellor, I present Dr. Zimbizi.
Lauren Elizabeth Taylor. Dr. Taylor's studies were undertaken in the discipline of medical science under the supervision of Associate Professor Lionel Hubbard, Dr. Craig McFarlane, and Dr. Ira Cook.
Chancellor, Dr. Taylor studied the role of cell adhesion molecules in skeletal muscle regeneration. She found that this molecule, a combination of an andepicin, negatively regulates skeletal muscle regeneration. This data will have significant ramifications for improving muscle generation in patients with muscle loss. Chancellor, I present Dr. Taylor.
Jia Zhang. Dr. Zhang's studies were undertaken in the discipline of genetics under the supervision of Dr. Ira Cook and Professor David Miller.
Chancellor, Dr. Zhang's research undertook an in-depth study of Acropia coral population genomics using whole genome sequencing data. Her focus was the genetic diversity and evolution of these corals in the Great Barrier Reef and Kimberley, northwestern Australia. The study's findings enhance our understandings of coral speciation and provide projections on coral adaptability to future climate changes. Chancellor, I present Dr. Zheng.
Swapna Vikas Chandray. Dr. Chandray's studies were undertaken in the discipline of pharmacy under the supervision of Professor Beverly Glass and Associate Professor Robin Ray.
Chancellor, Dr. Chaudhary designed, delivered and evaluated the first online transgender healthcare training program for Australian pharmacists, which improved knowledge, attitudes and behaviour in their delivery of transgender healthcare. She developed novel gender inclusivity pharmacy framework, which will enhance the development and elevation of future training programs in transgender healthcare. Chancellor, I present Dr. Chaudhary.
Patricia Elise Field. Dr. Field's studies were undertaken in the discipline of health under the supervision of Professor Richard Franklin, Dr. Ruth Barker, and the late Emeritus Professor Peter Leggett, AM, ADC.
Chancellor, Dr. Field investigated access to cardiac rehabilitation, CR, in rural and remote areas of North Queensland. She found that understanding provision and access to CR were inadequate and a proposed heart road to health to address these issues. The results are being discussed within Queensland Health, Indigenous and community organisations. Chancellor, I present Dr. Field.
Louise Carolyn Miles. Dr. Miles' studies were undertaken in the discipline of occupational therapy under the supervision of Associate Professor Fiona Barnett and Dr. Jackie Eagers.
Chancellor, Dr. Miles studied how and why Australian adult hand grip strength is assessed, including what factors most strongly predict hand grip strength. Biological factors, including age, gender, height, hand length and width, and forearm circumference, and functional factors like work and lifestyle demands. These have significant influence on HGS and should be considered when evaluating hand grip strength. Chancellor, I present Dr. Miles.
Catherine June Cameron. Dr. Cameron's studies were undertaken in the discipline of archaeology under the supervision of Dr. Nigel Chang and Professor Sean Olm.
Chancellor, Dr. Cameron explored the lives of people that lived and worked in previous unknown copper mining community in Laos 3,000 to 1,300 years ago. She analysed the style and technology of their pottery, uncovering an unexpected link to the Iron Age of Sa Huynh culture in central Vietnam. Chancellor, I present Dr. Cameron.
Musa Aurora David Chinafunga. Dr. Chinafunga's studies were undertaken in the discipline of education studies under the supervision of Dr. Philemon Chingzia and Dr. Barat Taylor.
Chancellor, Dr. Chinafunga investigated student participation in calculus-based senior secondary maths in Queensland and pedagogical resources that enhance teaching of mathematics. Trends analysis reveals a high dropout rate. David also found that pedagogical resources that compromise procedural flowcharts and concept maps can enrich mathematics teaching and promote student participation and engagement. Chancellor, I present Dr. Chinafunga.
Narelle Evelyn Delibate. Dr. Delibate's studies were undertaken in the discipline of creative arts under the supervision of Associate Professor Robin Glade Wright, Professor Ryan Daniel and Dr. Christy Giselson.
Chancellor, Dr. Delibate explores the concept of inherent beauty of women through photographic practices. She found that hydromorphic portraits of women are created through photographic processes of facelessness, of dark aesthetic, distortion, blurring and abstraction. These photographic processes disrupt the objectifying gaze and challenge idealised representations of female beauty. Chancellor, I present Dr. Delibate.
Vicky Ann Dunk. Dr. Dunk's studies were undertaken in the discipline of education studies under the supervision of Associate Professor Helen Boone, Dr. Tanya Doyle and Dr. Pam McGraw.
Chancellor, Dr. Dunk studied nursing and allied health students' use of self-regulated learning strategies in their foundation bioscience subjects. She developed an integrated intervention to help students gain proficiency in using these learning strategies to assist them to improve their academic achievement in this important content area. Chancellor, I present Dr. Dunk.
Tiana Killoran. Dr. Killoran's studies were undertaken in the discipline of history under the supervision of Dr. Claire Brennan, Dr. Anna Hayes and Professor Russell McGregor.
Chancellor, Dr. Killoran researched the history of Japanese community in North Queensland between 1885 and 1946. She found that this community of migrants made substantial contributions to the region's social, cultural and economic life and played a significant role within Australia's transnational diplomatic and political connections during the 20th century. Chancellor, I present Dr. Killoran.
Linda Louise Llewellyn. Dr. Llewellyn's studies were undertaken in the discipline of education studies under the supervision of Dr. Kerry McKay Smith and Professor Martin Nakata AM.
Chancellor, Dr. Llewellyn canvassed her Indigenous community for supportive teaching strategies in response to Indigenous students' removal from classrooms. These were examined using mixed methods, quantitative Rash and chi-squared analysis, and qualitative observation interviews methodologies. It was found culturally appropriate strategies have the potential to redress student removals. Chancellor, I present Dr. Llewellyn.
Poangtip Kurdsap. Dr. Kurdsap's studies were undertaken in the discipline of archaeology under the supervision of Dr. Nigel Chang and Professor Rosita Henry.
Chancellor, Dr. Kurdsap studied spindle whorls to develop insights into everyday lives of people in ancient Thailand. Spindle whirls were important tools for cloth making. Poyalatip found that both environmental and cultural factors are reflected in whirl form. This demonstrates how artefact studies reveal the lived experience of archaeological communities. Chancellor, I present Dr. Kurtzap.
Chancellor, as we proceed with the acknowledgement of our Doctor of Philosophy graduates, the following candidate deserves special recognition. In acknowledgement of academic excellence, the university bestows an award upon graduates whose doctoral research theses have been passed cum laude. In honour of this exceptional achievement, the graduate will be presented with the Medal of Excellence for Doctoral Research Thesis, a mark of distinction within our academic community. Chancellor, I present a graduate so honoured. Shaway Visnathan Kananidi. Dr. Kananidi's studies were undertaken in the discipline of biological sciences under the supervision of Professor Andreas Lopata, Dr. Sandip Kamawath, and Dr. Ira Cook.
Chancellor, Dr. Kananidi studied allergic proteins in shellfish and edible insects. He developed a novel protocol that identified the complete repertoire of allergens in shrimps, determined clinical relevance of shrimp allergens to develop shellfish immunotherapy, and identified unique cross-reactive allergens in edible insects that are clinically significant to people with shellfish allergy. Chancellor, I present Dr. Kananidi.
Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of the Doctor of Philosophy Awards.
Chancellor, I invite Associate Professor David Simcock, Acting Dean of the College of Public Health, Medical and Veterinary Sciences, to present the college graduates.
Chancellor, I present a graduate admitted to the degree of the Bachelor of Biomedical Sciences, Callum Somerled Robertson. Chancellor, I present a graduate admitted to the degree of the Bachelor of Biomedical Sciences Honours with distinction, Rowena Liz Robin Tekekara. Chancellor, I present a graduate admitted to the degree of the Bachelor of Life Sciences, Kimberly Janice Bovey. Chancellor, I present a graduate admitted to the degree of the Bachelor of Medical Laboratory Science Honours, Meda Chetuvedi. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of the Bachelor of Veterinary Science, Duval Bulta. Taylor Marie Gilbert. Jadine Sarah Lauder. Chanel Kach Young. Lucy Alice Smith. Chancellor, I present a graduate admitted to the degree of the Master of Medical Science with distinction and awarded the Australian Institute of Medical Scientists Tropical Division Prize, Sathini Amaya Hathrasinghe. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of the Master of Public Health, Master of Business Administration, Karandi Ludi Kupeng. Kathy Rose Marino. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Master of Public Health and Tropical Medicine, Emma Kate Pavey. Alfred Tongan Bayer. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Master of Public Health and Master of Tropical Medicine with distinction and the Rick Spear Medal, Anna Alexandra Caitlin Van der Say. Gemma Elise Wormsley. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of graduates from the College of Public Health, Medical and Veterinary Sciences.
Chancellor, I invite Professor Pauline Kalija, Dean of the College of Healthcare Sciences, to present the graduates from the Colleges of Healthcare Sciences and Medicine and Dentistry.
Chancellor, I present a graduate awarded the degree of Associate Degree of Health Sciences, Isabel Paris Collins. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Bachelor of Nursing Science, Sarah Marie Newman. Alicia Marie Terrell. Chancellor, I present graduates awarded to the degree of Graduate Certificate of Diabetes Education, Caroline Paterno. Tatiana Zosimova. Chancellor, I present a graduate awarded the degree of Graduate Certificate of Diabetes Education with Distinction, Kate Ann Mannion. Chancellor, I present graduates awarded the degree of Graduate Diploma of Psychology, Samantha Albertini. Diana Gay Cheatley. Caitlin Michelle Coombe. Kira Ann Reed. Glenn Thomas Stevens. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Master of Nursing, Timothy Wayne Bright. Talia Brooke Doyle Nyberg. Christine Eads. Rosemary Kasitstra. Juliana Dawn Madan. Ketra Motembani. Hilda Clara Obsinana. Matthew John Pasco. Madeline Elizabeth Paulson. Michelle Bourbon Ramos. Lucinda Louise Stewart. Sabina Thakuri. Joanne May Wilson. Scott Andrew Worthy. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Master of Nursing with Distinction, Renee Ethel Siciliano. Jade Therese Wright. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Master of Psychology Clinical, Leah Jane Crisp. Monique Phoebe DeCan. Mayjoy Obak. Chancellor, I present a graduate awarded the degree of Graduate Certificate of Health Professional Education, Rebecca Taylor. Chancellor, I present a graduate awarded the degree of Graduate Diploma of Surgical Anatomy with Distinction, Joshua Cavour. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of graduates from the Colleges of Healthcare Sciences and Medicine and Dentistry.
Chancellor, I invite Professor Cohen Staplebrook, Dean of the College of Arts, Society and Education, to present the college graduates.
Chancellor, I present graduates awarded the degree of Diploma of Tertiary Studies, Shana Kristen Wilson. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Adam Christopher Brown. Ashley Grace Kane. Jermaine Daryl Chong. Cody Fo. Tegan Lee Foster. Cherise Erica Horsberg. Sharon Jemutai Kimite. Paige Kippen. Mackenzie Grace Knight. Brendan John Matthews. Bryn Joseph McClure Griggs. Hilda Robert Mollell. Elena Rose Moore. Lorenza Giulia Palombi. Jessica Lali Parker. Brooke Louise Pierce. Penny Louise Pierce. Amber Crystal Eden Pomeroy. Jared Andrew Lynch Terry. Sonali Viapu. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Bachelor of Arts with distinction, the Colin Roderick Prize for English Honours, Jade Samia Croft. The Elizabeth Perkins Prize for Creative Writing and the H. Neil Smith Prize and the Colin Roderick Prize in Children's Literature and the Rick Thomas Inclusion Award, Tracy Lee Ann Howe. Alina Wendy Reynolds. And Dean Prize for English Literature, and the Douglas Sutter's Memorial Prize, and the Howard Fry Prize in Southeast Asian Studies, and the Colin Roderick Prize for English Honours, Joanna Wiggers. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Bachelor of Arts Honours Class 1, the Robert Mays Memorial Prize, Amaya Louise Marson. The P.F. Rowland Memorial Prize, Chelsea Lee Rolls. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Bachelor of Education, Ayona Pauline Anderson. Crystal Lee Beckman. Annika Jane Barth. Aiden Michael Bennett. Casey Ann Bplate. Chloe Olivia Burgess. Angel Grace Camp. Alexandria Louise Clark. Danielle Lynn Klaus. Jesse Blake Corbett. Alexandria Madison Cox. Lexis Ayn Dinan. Domenico Farina. Jenna Marie Green. Mitchell Peter Golson. Paris Elizabeth Hart. Poppy Leilani Hazel. Brendan Thomas Alexander Hill. Clara Louise Jensen. Molly Roma Johnson. Alana Tia Jordan. Jenna Kate Michelle Lansbury. Hannah Michelle Laws. Nicholas James Leavesley. The Catholic Education Townsville Diocese Prize, Melissa Ann Lovell. Anna Cavill Minahan. Brooke Christine O'Brien. Hannah Elsie O'Donnell. Michaela Valerie Osborne. Kelsey Louise Pownell. Peter Ashley Prince. Jacinta Russo. Hamish Kit Scott. Talia Catherine Scott. Bryony Joyce Jackson. Matthew Michael Verri. Rachel Ann Ward. Jacqueline Ann Weston. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Bachelor of Education with distinction, the Pam Gilbert Memorial Prize and the Ross Smith Prize and the Sarah Power Memorial Prize, Carly Nicole Bouter. The Queensland Association of State Schools Principals Primary Prize and the Primary English Teaching Association of Australia Award for Excellence, Gemma Haley Flanagan. The Queensland Association of Mathematics Teacher Prize, Townsville, Jessie Marie Zevenbergen. Chancellor, I present a graduate admitted to the degree of Bachelor of Educational Service, Kim Cherry Phyllis Nunn. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Bachelor of Social Work, Narita Jane Anderson. Lee Richard Bolsover. the Australian Association of Social Workers North Queensland Townsville Prize, Juanita Helen Digar. Annalise Belinda Freeman. Katie May Mary Green. Susan Jack. Elizabeth Corrine Corpi. Stacy Nicole Mamino. Ashu Ayang Mawin. Jennifer Jane Nielsen. Melissa Jane Ross. The Pauline Lawrence Social Work Practice Prize, Willow Rose Shore. Gillian Dorothy Sim. Sian Amber Stones. Drew Macy Vickers. Chancellor, I present a graduate admitted to the degree of Bachelor of Social Work with distinction, Melissa Ann Piper. Chancellor, I present graduates awarded the degree of Graduate Certificate of Career Development, Debbie Patricia Price. Chancellor, I present graduates awarded the degree of Graduate Certificate of Career Development with distinction, Deborah Marie Kane. Chancellor, I present a graduate awarded the degree of Graduate Certificate of Global Development, William John Archibald Novell. Chancellor, I present a graduate awarded the degree of Graduate Certificate of Indigenous Studies, Jane Patricia Arlett. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Master of Guidance and Counseling, Boside Homawunme Hadaibeyi. Margot Loring Cook. Marcel Louise Foster. Joseph Benjamin Gerard O'Halloran. Alicia Mayvella. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Master of Guidance and Counseling with distinction, Deborah Leonie Barra Howard. Molly Bettridge. Tracy Simongori. Amelia Humphrey. Michelle F.T.A. Kotsas. Cassandra Little. Diana Mijovic. Rebecca Leslie Milton. Catherine Ray George O'Flaherty. Dominic Vittorio Pino. Maxine Monica Regan. Amy Catherine Runham. Amy Ellen Sheehan. Cameron William Toriano Turton. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Master of Social Work Professional Qualifying, Samantha Davidson. Mighty Susan Dotla. Eamon Mary Vincent. Megana Reddy Gate. Dwani Manishbhai Gandhi. Louisa Elizabeth Goikuchea. Chow Lee Guo. Sagar Emmanuel Joby. Fergus Khan. Shan Lee. Gaufami Manohar. Sneha Mathur. Nobulo Natasha Modisakeng. Sandra Paul Sebastian. Varun Kumar Varadka Krishna Pillai. Sherin Rajan. Anju Reji. Ananya Vets. Yiju Yu. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Master of Social Work Professional Qualifying with Distinction, Sally Elise Farley. Afri Mara Gregory. Courtney Ann Hopes. Olufemi Afolabi Ogundinyo. Catherine Marie Smith. Aishwarya Thomas. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Master of Teaching and Learning, Lillian Ellis Jones. Jake Stephen Peffer. Teacher had Achille Cockburn. Vian Sengi Yumva. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Master of Teaching and Learning with distinction, Catherine Ann Goldsworthy. Rowan Carl Greedy. Theresa Margaret Mops. Chancellor, I present a graduate admitted to the degree of Master of Philosophy, Christiane Schultz. Chancellor, I present graduates admitted to the degree of Master of Philosophy Indigenous, Samantha Gay Reynard. And the Dean's Award for Excellence, Tamara May Sam. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of graduates from the College of Arts, Society and Education.
Chancellor, I call upon the Chair of Academic Board, Professor Stephen Naylor, to present recipients of a university medal.
Chancellor, as we proceed with the presentation of college graduates, the following student deserves special recognition. Each year, the University Council awards university medals to students who, in qualifying for their degree, have shown outstanding achievements in a combination of coursework studies, research at the undergraduate level. Chancellor, I present one student so honoured. Admitted to the degree of Bachelor of Arts Honours Class 1, awarded the Anne Dean Prize for English Literature, the Colin Roderick Prize for Australian Literature Prize B, the Ross Smith Prize, the Colin Roderick Prize for Critical Theory, and the Colin Roderick Prize for English Honours, Townsville. Carla Anna Lee Di Stefani. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of university medals.
Chancellor, I have great pleasure in introducing this afternoon's occasional speaker, Mr. Sean Chilburgh. Sean is a charismatic and vibrant performer and cultural ambassador. He has carved his niche in Australia as Australia's number one Indigenous entertainer, captivating audiences with traditional dance, didgeridoo, storytelling, knowledge and humour. Sean's ancestors are the Gugu Yalanji, Kalkadoon, Kanju, Giramay and Bukaman people from around Townsville and Palm Island. He has toured schools and colleges throughout Australia, Canada, Japan, and New Zealand over the past 15 years. Hailing from Townsville, Sean has an established career as a dancer. He created the Nauru Dance Company and performed all over the world with the Bangarra Dance Company, including by invitation for the Dalai Lama, Hale and Pace, and Prince Charles. But these days, Sean is in constant demand as an MC and comedian for official functions, corporate events, theatre shows, comedy clubs, workshops, openings, and festivals. Chancellor, I invite Mr. Sean Chilbara to deliver the occasional address.
Hello, everyone. Hey. I just wanted to, before I started, I wanted to just quickly do the formalities before we get a little informal, yeah? Chancellor, Vice Chancellor, and President, Deputy Chancellor, members of Council, members of staff, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and most importantly, the graduates. So I just want to congratulate all of you guys. Yeah, I grew up here in Townsville, in the 1960s, my dad was born 1920, my mum was born 1930. They were born on Palm Island, and we came off the island in the mid-60s. I have seven brothers, four sisters, and we went to school here. We went to Catholic school, went to St. Ignatius Park College. And it was there I got kicked out of grade 11, and and here I am. and I actually still go back to Ignatius Park, or Iggy Park as we call it, and talk there and do shows for the students there. I pretty much wanted to find out where I fit in society or in life, I guess. And having a dad who was absent, who lived across the road here in the park, and slept there and drank. And I remember seeing him one time, and he said, "Don't ever let me catch you down here where your dad lived, because he slept in the park." And I remember after seeing him, I got on my bicycle, I rode along, and I saw this black man in a suit carrying a briefcase. And I was like, "Wow, who's this guy?" And it was kind of like a crossroads, Here I was at this T-junction, I could go that way, I could go that way, and I found out the guy in the suit with the briefcase, his name was Marcus Pedro, and I said, "What do you do, Marcus?" He said, "I'm a DJ, and if you want to work for me, you can work for me and be a DJ." So I started working for Marcus Pedro for a few years. I was in Cairns, all the way down to Townsville here, in the small little towns along the way in the 1980s, DJing with him. And I was fresh out of high school, and basically I wanted to become a DJ, but I have to tell you where it all started for me. 10 years old, in the back of my house, playing cricket with a friend named Midgey Ross. 10 years old, and you got to have these sorts of people around you, and you certainly do. And he told me at 10 years old, because I was telling him a story, he said, you should do comedy and be a comedian. And I was like, "Yeah, okay." And I never really thought about it, but it always stayed in the back of my head, comedy. And I'd always listen to comedians and comedy and stuff like that. And, and then finally I went to Sydney. I studied music and dancing. And when I went down there, because it was hard for me to be a DJ in a place like Townsville, because it was hard enough me trying to be the DJ, let alone a lot of my people not being allowed in there in the first place as well. So I'm not playing victim, but my nephew's the DJ there now. But I decided, someone sent me an application to join a performing arts school in Sydney. I went down there, I studied dancing, studied every type of form of dancing, ballet, jazz, tap dancing, everything like that. You could imagine, when I went there, I started at 21, which is a bit late for a dancer. You normally start around 2 or 5 years old. And I was at the bottom of the class because everyone was so good, And after I do about, 9 to 5, our dance class were 9 to 5. I know it sounds like that Dolly Parton song, but 9 to 5. But anyway, Here I was, I'd be studying dancing. I'd walk all the way there. And as I'd walk to the dance theater on Parramatta Road in Petersham, Stanmore, whatever it is, I'd see the Sydney Comedy Store. And it kind of hit me there. And I go, man, I should be in there doing comedy, you know? And I kept going to dance class. And I'd, after dance class, I'd walk all the way back to the hostel where we all lived all our stances. I'd have some dinner, get on a bus and take off again and go into the city and do extra dance classes, do extra ballet, whatever. I was very fortunate to get asked to join one of the greatest dance companies in the world, Bangara Dance Company. And from there, it gave me an idea to form my own dance company, traveling the world, places like New York City, Scotland, London, all these kind of places. thank you. And as a result, I get to, do all that. And you would think I was happy with being a dancer. And, I kind of felt like, I was meant to do something I was really meant to do since I was told at 10 years old to do stand-up comedy. I finally walked into a comedy place, and I sat there and I watched all these comedians do 5 minutes, open mic nights, and all that kind of stuff. Now, this was a time when there was no such thing as an Aboriginal person doing stand-up comedy in clubs. There was jokes about my people constantly before and after comedians who came on would often tell these sort of jokes. And I remember saying to my brother, man, they're telling like jokes about us, you know? And he said, man, you're in the wrong industry if you don't have thick skin. You know, you got to have thick skin and you got to come up with, routines that are a bit more clever and a bit more better than that kind of stuff, yeah? So here I walked into the comedy club and, I wrote a joke, and I remember performing with all these comedians, Will Anderson. These days I tour with the Aboriginal Comedy All-Stars or Jamowin and things like that, and I remember one comedian who was from Egypt, who's a good friend of mine named Akmal Salih. And Akmal said, man, you got to get on the footy show. And I said, how do I get on the footy show? He said, just write them a letter, send them a video or something like that. And at the time, all the comedians were trying to get on this footy show, Channel 9 Rugby League footy show. And this was probably about 20-odd years ago, and I wrote them a letter. Had someone videotape me, sent it in, and they rang me up, and they said, Sean, we want you on the footy show. And I told this joke, and I don't know if I'm allowed to tell this joke anymore because it's, like, banned in 12 different countries. And But I said to myself that day, I was sitting in the green room, and I said to myself, I want to be like a comedian that went on 3 times that year, and his name was Carl Barron. And I said, I want to be like him. I want to be on the footy show 3 times. And I said it quietly in the green room, in the dressing room. The guy sharing the dressing room next to me was... He was Rob Schneider, whatever his name is. He's from a movie, Hollywood movie with Juice Bigelow and stuff like that, yeah? So he gave me some words of advice too, yeah? And here I was. I went on that year to do 3 times. And I got on the best of, comedians on the DVD. And I was collecting a royalty check that I didn't even have you're collecting a royalty check for it. And when I got that royalty check, it had $124. And I was like, yes, I'm rich, yeah? So and it was never about money or anything like that. It was just about bettering, this where I grew up. There was a situation. And I moved back here after years of traveling around, having my own children, stuff like that, and a few wives later and things like that. And I moved back because COVID hit, and I had no work or anything like that. And my brother said, why don't you go and pick some mangoes? And I said, I'd rather pick peaches. And here I was picking peaches, and I was living on just eating peaches. And when you take stuff from work, it's not really stealing, but if you get caught, it is stealing. But anyway, you know what I mean. Here I was eating peaches, and on the news, Donald Trump was being impeached, and I was like, my goodness, this guy is the same color as a peach, yeah, and he's being impeached. That's like being black and being blacklisted, yeah, or being white and being privileged. Ah, no, all right, sorry, All right, I didn't mean to bring color into it, but on Friday night I enjoyed pink, yeah? It was good, yeah? I think my missus, she said to me, can you get us pink tickets? And I said, yes, okay. And I put it on social media, which is a silly thing to do. I said, anyone selling their tickets? And this guy named Manuel wrote to me and said, yeah, $200 each. And I didn't realize I was getting scammed at the time, yeah? $450 later, it was about 3:30 in the afternoon. And pink concert's kind of kicking off, you know, 5 or 6 p.m. And here I was, you know, and I think that's the thing that you're going to have in life. You know, you're going to always have, you know, obstacles or anything like that. And you just got to go through with it. It is life. You got to welcome it and then you got to let it go. And here I was during the COVID time. I had no work, had no future of any type of work. I was going to pick mangoes out the back of Ross River Dam. Put on these boots that have steel on the top of it. And I was like, man, I came from a dance school where we have steel underneath it. You know, bam, we're tap dancing, you know? And I did what everyone does around 4:30 in the morning on your way to work. I checked the email. And the email said, it was from a movie director from Brisbane who said, Sean, I've been looking for you and I like your voice. And I'm writing a cartoon. I want you to play one of these characters in this cartoon. Anyway, the cartoon is called Bluey, and here I was about to go mango picking, and I called in, and I said, I'm going to do a cartoon now, and I'm sorry, and I'm not going to make it in. So the Bluey cartoons kind of, you know, blew up all around the world, and picked up, you know, my work again, I guess, and man, here I am today at this, and basically, very, very, very honored, you know, to come and speak and you know, just tell you a little bit about my story, you know, the interesting parts of it, and you know, always the ups and downs of it, but also it's always, you know, it's your destiny. However you graduate, you know, like it's I know the hard work, because when I lived in Sydney, I lived in Sydney for 32 years, and I was homesick all the time, yeah? And now I've moved back, and I'm like, yes, you know, I just feel so good being back home here in Townsville, and even though I've seen the world, you know, I've seen whatever, you know, been overseas to Magnetic Island. Nah, Palm Island. But anyway, I just want to congratulate you guys again, and good luck with your journeys, and just have fun and just enjoy it. And you know, my motto is don't take life too serious. You know, you get sometimes it'll hit you, but you know, you'll look back and you'll go, man, those hardest moments were the best times. Like when I was at dance school with a whole bunch of strangers, you know, and you're at the bottom of the class and no one's even paying any attention to you and all that kind of stuff, and then here you are, you go do all these extra classes, and you're the only one in your whole dance class that rises and joins the dance company, and now they're all your friends, and you don't hold any grudge or anything like that. You just go, thank you, yeah, and you know, you do it for you, but you don't do it for anything else besides your kids and stuff like that. But anyway, thank you guys, thank you very much, thank you.
Chancellor, I now have the pleasure of inviting Renee Siciliano to deliver the graduate address.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor and President, Occasional Speaker, Mr. Sean Chubara, members of the official party, distinguished guests, members of staff, ladies and gentlemen, fellow graduates. I'm grateful to James Cook University for the privilege of delivering the graduate address. Today marks a significant milestone in our lives, a day brimming with emotions, achievements, and aspirations. I studied in the College of Healthcare Sciences, and I'm representing graduates from the College of Public Health, Medical and Veterinary Sciences, College of Medicine and Dentistry, and College of Arts, Society, and Education. Although we have studied with different colleges, we are bound by a shared experience. that has shaped us, challenged us, and ultimately brought us together for this moment of celebration and reflection. Firstly, I'd like to express thanks to our occasional speaker, Mr. Sean Chulbara. Your address was nothing short of inspiring. Thank you for taking the time to share your experiences and insights with us. Your passion for the arts was palpable, and your commitment to excellence served as a shining example for all of us to aspire to. We appreciate your invaluable contribution to our event. Your presence has truly enriched our gathering, and we are grateful for the opportunity to learn from you. I would like to ask the audience to show your appreciation with a round of applause for Mr. Sean Chulbara. We, the graduates, would like to extend our deepest gratitude to the faculty and staff of James Cook University, who have guided us along the path. Your dedication to teaching and expertise has been inspirational, leading to our success. As we reflect on our time at JCU, let us not forget the lessons we have learnt both inside and outside the classroom. Yes, we have mastered theories, solved equations, and written papers, but we have also learned the value of perseverance, the importance of collaboration, and the power of resilience. These are qualities that will serve us well as we navigate the challenges and opportunities that lie ahead. To our families and friends, here today or watching live, thank you for standing by us, cheering us on, and believing in our potential, even when we doubted ourselves. The unwavering support, encouragement, and understanding has led us here today. Your sacrifices have not gone unnoticed. I would like to ask all graduates to stand and turn towards the audience and applaud your supporters. To my fellow graduates, we have journeyed through countless hours of study, endured moments of doubt, and celebrated triumphs big and small. But through it all, we have emerged stronger, wiser, and ready to take on the world. As we embark on the next chapter, let us embrace the unknown with courage and curiosity. Let us never stop learning, growing, and pushing the boundaries of what is possible. Congratulations, class of 2024. Our adventure begins now. Let us make it a journey of purpose, passion, and enduring impact. Thank you.
Chancellor, I now invite Vice-Chancellor and President, Professor Simon Biggs, to deliver the closing address.
Chancellor, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, my university colleagues, and most importantly, of course, our graduates. It is my privilege to deliver the closing words at this graduation ceremony. Graduates, I am aware that I do not have the talent of Sean Chulbara, so I will attempt to be brief. As I know, you are keen to enjoy the rest of your day with your family, friends, and loved ones, enjoying your momentous achievements. Firstly, let me convey my very best congratulations to you all, as you join the ranks of our many distinguished alumni here at James Cook University. Throughout your time at our university, you have all been important members of a very diverse community, encompassing a multitude of students with very different experiences and perspectives from across Australia and indeed around the world. This cultural diversity isn't just something we acknowledge. It's something that we celebrate as a vital part of our university's ethos. In your interactions with peers from various backgrounds, you have been afforded the opportunity to broaden your horizons, challenge your assumptions, and gain a deeper understanding of those around you and our wider world. As you continue on your journey, I encourage you to carry these experiences with you and recognize the value that diverse views and opinions bring. Engage with others at every opportunity with an open mind, with empathy and with compassion, Welcome the uniqueness of individuals you encounter and respect these varied perspectives. This will undoubtedly enrich your own growth, both personally and professionally, advancing your own growth as well as helping progress in our communities. Whilst we celebrate the diversity of our community here at JCU, we must also recognize the ongoing reality of inequality and injustice in our own community. Many members of our local communities here in the North face considerable hurdles if they are to pursue their dreams of an education. I was recently privileged to go out west and explore some of the towns and communities that our university was established to serve. Equality of access to a high-quality education and to healthcare remains something we are yet to solve in this country. As part of our JCU community, and now as you join our alumni, always remember that each of us can be a champion for positive change. Always stand up for what is fair and just. Do what is right, and help us to ensure that every individual can eventually be given an equal opportunity to succeed. As you embark on your exciting journey ahead, know that you carry with you the spirit of social justice, fairness, and equity that is deeply ingrained in our university. Approach the future with optimism and determination, knowing that you can be part of creating a more inclusive, compassionate, and equitable future for all. Graduates, you are influencers of change and progress. You can inspire hope, cultivate empathy, and foster a sense of belonging for all. Embrace the future with open hearts, open minds, and optimism, and help build a world unified by its diversity, not one divided by its differences. Your future is brimming with endless possibilities, and we look forward to seeing the incredible things you are going to achieve. So on behalf of the entire university community, I extend to you my sincerest congratulations and best wishes. May your future endeavors be filled with success and fulfillment. Graduates, goodbye and good luck. And remember that you will always have a home here at JCU. So until we meet again, go out there and make us all proud. Congratulations.
Chancellor, the successful staging of this ceremony is the culminative effort of many university staff. I would like to thank the University Graduations and Events Officers for the coordination of this ceremony. This graduation ceremony has now concluded. Will the Assembly please stand as the Chancellor leads the academic procession from the auditorium?